Surf fishing is incredibly easy if you know what you're doing. What's going on? This is Ryan from The Real GPU, and today we're going to talk a little bit about surf fishing. So I was recently on vacation. I went to Panama City Beach, which is in the Florida Panhandle. It's one of the best beaches that I have ever been to. It is very isolated. There's not a lot of people. White sand, clear water. It's called the Emerald Coast for a reason. But that's besides the point, I guess. I ended up going fishing for a little bit in Panama City. It wasn't for too long, or at least successful fishing wasn't for too long. But I learned some tips and tricks to catch fish while surf fishing. This can apply to any beach, really, but especially in Florida and especially in the Florida Panhandle. So just to give you some backstory, I spent about a day and a half just tossing out like a bucktail jig, trying to get it past the second sandbar. Because the way that surf fishing works is, so you're on a beach and there's two sandbars. So there's a sandbar, then a drop off, then another sandbar, and then kind of what's open ocean. And the goal is to get your bait or your lure past that second sandbar. If you've ever gone to a pier, the pier extends to the point where you are past the second sandbar, and then you can catch a whole variety of different fish. So I was trying to, you know, kind of just cast past the second sandbar, you know, just use my bucktail jig, try to catch a couple fish. Nothing was working. I tried using my banjo minnow. That didn't work either. So I was kind of just wondering, what do I need to do to catch fish here? And a lot of people were wondering the same thing, which is kind of why I wanted to make this video. A lot of people are asking people that were fishing there, like, oh, what are you using? Are you catching anything? And usually the answer was, I'm using this and I'm not catching anything. But then a friend of mine suggested something that really, really helped. And I wish I would have used it a lot longer, because I ended up fishing with this rig for about half an hour. Caught like 6 fish. And I wish I would have learned about it sooner. I would have caught a ton of fish over the 3 or 4 days that I was there. So for this video, we are going to be talking about the Pompano rig. As the name suggests, it targets Pompano, which are, they're really anywhere. I was out like swimming in the beach, and they're really just anywhere. You can just cast your line anywhere, just out into the water, and you'll catch anything between Pompano, Whiting, and a variety, maybe like pinfish or something like that. So the first thing to know is the Pompano rig. That is important. I will go over the Pompano rig in just a little bit. So there are a couple of things that you want to keep in mind when you're surf fishing. And this is just something that I was not aware of until I got this tip from my friend. So when you're surf fishing, a lot of the fish like sand fleas. Sand fleas are basically these little crustaceans. They're like this big. You can find them on the beach. What you can actually do if you want to catch them, get a net. Go to like where the surf is washing up to your feet, and as like the surf pulls back into the ocean, you'll sometimes see sand fleas jump out of the wet sand and go towards the water. And if you have a net, you can just block their path and scoop them up like that. You can also find them like dead throughout the beach. Just look for them, and you can use that as bait. But what I find even more efficient is this guy right here. All right, this is what's called Fishbites. Alright, it's like almost like a Laffy Taffy, really. It's just this like really long strip of artificial bait that comes in a variety of different scents. And this particular one is sand flea scent, which is really liked by Pompano and Whiting and all that. It definitely works. This orange color, if I'm not mistaken, resembles like the sand fleas and their eggs and all that, just like the red beads on this Pompano rig. So this is the rig itself. So you have this swivel right here that obviously attaches to your line. Then you have one hook here with a bead that again resembles like a sand flea egg. You have another hook right here. And then you have this piece right here. And what you're gonna do with that is you're gonna unclip it and you're gonna add a surf weight to it. Now there are a variety of different surf weights. There are some that look like little pyramids, and they're made of lead. And just the goal of it is to keep your Pompano rig on the sand, because obviously when there's like a lot of surf, when the current is just really, really going, your lure or the rig, the Pompano rig, is going to move all over the place, but you really want it to just sit. Because the thing about surf fishing is essentially you just cast it, you put your rod on like a PVC pipe or a metal rod holder that goes into the sand, and then you just wait. So the easiest way to accomplish that is by adding a surf weight. So the one that I have here, it's just a simple, you know, piece of lead. It has these like metal parts and little beads on them, which again resembles the sand flea eggs. And you're gonna add that right to this little piece right here. And then of course, on the hooks, you're gonna add the fish bites. So if you're specifically targeting like whiting and pompano, use the sand flea scented fish bites. Those work phenomenally. When I was in Panama City, I was using fish bites and my dad was using actual sand fleas, and I was having a ton of success with the fish bites and he didn't catch a single fish. Now, I actually recorded some fishing in Panama City Beach with the Pompano rig. The only problem is I did not have that surf weight until after I got back. So what I tried to do is I tried to tie with a fishing line, like an egg weight, to the little like metal piece where you attach the weight. And after like my third cast, it flew off my Pompano rig. And I was really disappointed because that essentially just killed my rig. My improvisation did not work. But then I started catching fish. So I wanted to add some backstory and kind of an explanation about the Pompano rig and when you can use it before I brought in this footage, because it's not very structured and it's not like a true Pompano rig. But I just want to show you how effective that rig can be, because again, this was over like half an hour and had a lot of success, didn't even use the rig correctly. This is just showing you the possibilities of catching fish, especially in Florida and the Florida Panhandle, using a Pompano rig and fish bites. So take a look at the success that I had.
A 2-for-1! Oh, it de-hooked! Oh, I had two! And put on one of these instead of the sand fleas. It's like candy!
Now I know there's not a lot of footage here because I did actually catch two before I went and got my camera, because I honestly didn't think this was gonna work. I just hope you guys learned something, how to fish on the beach, because again, like I said, there were a lot of people fishing on that beach that just were not catching, and they were very desperate, asking a lot of questions, you know, what are you using? And nobody knew what was working. But using a pompano rig with a surf weight and sandflea scented fish bites can catch you a ton of fish. We only caught whiting here, but that's because the pompano weren't running. If you go around the springtime, I believe, the pompano are everywhere. And yeah, I hope you learned something about surf fishing. It's really not that hard. So that's gonna do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe. I like to do a whole bunch of fishing videos. I try to fish in as many places that I can. It's not always easy. But yeah, if you really like those fishing videos, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I'll do my best to provide more fishing content. So again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.